Actually, I'm a little out of breath, but I made it to the top of the mountain over here. Everyone, get out. Get out and do some walking. It's good. It's good. It's good for your neshama. It's good for your body. It's good for everything. Mentioned in the last video about the cancellation, canceling the past and moving to the forward. The cancellation is so deep that for a few months, our communal experience in shul was completely canceled. There was no davening with a minyan across the Jewish world. First time in history, I think, something like this happened. There has to be something very deep. And many people are talking about, you know, we're going back to shul, shuls are opening up, and in a sense, not so fast, because we think we're going back, and then suddenly it spikes again, and there's a whole issue, can you not? The way I see it is, there's no going back. This whole business of going back is absolutely ridiculous. We didn't have to cancel all of our, you know, davening in shul with a minyan and all the yeshivas and the kaisel was canceled and 770 was canceled, just that we should go back to same old, same old. It's absolutely unacceptable. There's no going back. There's only going forward. We need to go to the Beis HaMikdash. That's it. Ki beis beis tefila yekara l'chol ha'amim. You know, the place of davening now is going to be in the Beis HaMikdash, Karbonos, and so on and so forth. I was in a mimer from the Alter Rebbe in Lakuti Torah on Parsha Shalach, on the pasuk Ani Hashem Alekechem. So in the last pasuk of Kriya Shema, we say both two times Ani Hashem Alekechem. Ani Hashem Alekechem in the beginning, Asher Tzeisi Eschem Eretz Mitzrayim, Liyos Lachem Lelekim, Ani Hashem Alekechem. What's the repetition of Ani Hashem Alekechem? So the Alter Rebbe says, what does it mean, I am God, your God? He explains it to mean something like this. I'm just rewording. Or the idea of Ani Hashem Alekechem means, I'm your God, means you're the one who captures my interests. You engage me. You involve me. You turn me on. That's the real meaning. Ani Hashem Alekechem. I am your God. I turn to you. You stimulate my involvement, my engagement in the world. The reason there's two levels of Ani Hashem Alekechem is because there is the Eibishter's engagement in the world, involvement and expression in the world until Mashiach comes, Bizman Azeh, and then there is the Eibishter's involvement and engagement in the world, in the future world, the world after Mashiach, we call Olam Haba. And it's an amazing difference. The involvement and the engagement of Hashem now is that in the Olam HaSalyonim, in the supernal realms, He is very, very, very present, very revealed, very, very experienced. And as we go down lower and lower, there's concealment and concealment. So until you get to the physical world where you see Gashmi, you see the physical, you don't see God. You don't see Hashem. When Mashiach will come, Hashem will be so present in the world that it will be equal. Olam Asiya, the physical world, and Olam Atzilus will be experiencing the same presence of the divine, the same imminence, the same intensity of the Eibishter's presence. And both these levels are stimulated by us. How? So the Alter Rebbe brings an amazing, but it says in the Gemara that when Yidden go to Beis HaKnesses, when Yidden go to Shul, and they say Amen Yehesh Mei Rabba, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Menaneya Beroishai. When we say Amen Yehesh Mei Rabba, we say Kaddish Amen Yehesh Mei Rabba, we cause Hashem to shake His head. What does it mean, God shakes His head? The head represents Hashem's Ratzain, and the skull, the main part of the head is the skull. And the skull is called Keser, is the Ratzin. We stimulate by Hashem a Ratzin. But he says the Ratzin that we stimulate currently is a much weaker Ratzin. It's a Ratzin that when Hashem flows as a result of that Ratzin, His interest is one of that is mitigated, that is limited enough that it can be blocked by the time it gets to the farthest, to the very time it extends out to the lowest and the most outer crust of existence, it's not felt. But the menanea beroishoi, the stimulating of the Eibishter's ratzon and will that's going to happen when Mashiach comes, it's going to be so intense that the godliness is going to burst with such an intensity that it's going to be felt in the most external levels of existence all the way out here. And that's why it's a whole new Hashanei Hashem Elokeichem. So to me it's clear that the fact that we've canceled going to shul, which causes HaKadosh Baruch Hu Menaneya Bereishai, is because the Ani Hashem Alekechem of the past is time that has ended. It's now it's time for the Ani Hashem Alekechem of the future. For the Ani Hashem Alekechem that doesn't allow a speck in the cosmos, a speck in the universe, which is not filled with the full brightness of Elikus. May we see that now.